All right. Generational sin. This is a very controversial topic. It's a very complicated topic, but I thought I would break it down in simplistic terms and give you an illustration of it so that you can apply it to your familial structure or your life as you were raised and the kind of family you were raised in, the kind of family tree that's above you, because we are all products of our family tree. Spiritually, genetically, emotionally, mentally, we all came out of our family tree. Boop, there we are. We're all related to our family tree. Genetics all came from somebody in your family tree. You look like somebody in your family tree. Could have been 3, 4, 5 generations earlier, but you know, they're there. You're there. You're there. Spiritually, 100% true. I have counseled numerous parents over the years who adopted children. And when they come to see me, they're in a state of living hell. Yeah? They adopted somebody, and nobody understands what I'm going to teach you tonight. That adopted kid came from another family tree. And now they've gone crazy. Why? We'll find out in a minute, but when you adopt a child, usually there's a problem with the child. It's very common now to have parents who are alcoholics, drug addicts, criminals, psychos, kooks, idiots, imbeciles, and people who abandon their kids. It's as run-of-the-mill now as anything in the world. And these kids are damaged. And they're spiritually damaged, and these people that are adopting them don't understand the spiritual ramifications of what I'm going to teach you tonight. And so they're sitting there, you know, with a pipe bomb in their house now, not understanding what happened and why this kid is acting the way it is. You'll find out in a minute. Generational sin, here it is. Let's go. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love not the world, the love of the Father is not in him. Now there's two Greek words for love, as you know. Agape. Agape is a noun. Agapao is a verb. Correct? So agape is the noun, and it means unconditional love. Agapao means to show it, to show that love. So if I say I love you, that means nothing. If I show you I love you, that he just agapakoed me. See that? See him give me a pat there? That's the verb. Okay. Unfortunately, in the King James Bible, this is not broken down well. And so some of the verses are a little bit difficult to interpret. But I mean, I'm having no problem interpreting. I'm just explaining it to you that love not the world. Do not show your love. Do not love the world and show it to the things of the world. Cosmos, a Greek word, means humanity, not the Greek word gay, which is the planet Earth. It's not talking about the world. It's talking about this world, us, right? Translation, do not show love and show your love toward things of humanity.